Hello class, in this video I am going to tell you the question which is given in your exercise from back in here. This question is page number 82 and question number page number 87 page number 87 and question number 62. Okay, what is this question? I'm reading the question. The question is, convert the following expression to the canonical sum of product. Okay, it means we have to convert, there is some expression is given and we have to convert those expression into the canonical sum of product. As earlier I have told you about the sum of product and product of sum. Okay, this question is on page number 87 and the question is question number 82. Okay, there are three questions. I am going to tell you only one and using the logic you will do the rest one. Okay, 61A, the question is x plus x bar y plus x bar z bar. Okay, this is the expression and we have to convert this expression into the canonical sum of product. Okay, here you can see some of you can ask that it is already in the sum of product, like there is x dot y, x dot z and x, and there is some sign, it is considered like a sum of product, but it is not a pure sum of product expression. Why? Because earlier I have told you about the min term and max term. Here you can see the total number of literals are 3. There are 3 literals. How? There is x, there is y and there is z also. It is not considered whether it is bar or not bar, but we have 3 literals, x, y and z. Using these 3 literals, this expression is created. Okay, so in this term you can see there is only one, there is x only. It means here y and z are missing. Here x bar and y are there but z is missing, and here x, z is there but y is missing. So using that missing rule we will apply and we will follow the that rule that earlier I have told. Okay, what is that? Just put the missing term, because it is already the sum sign is there, that's why just we will follow the missing term. Okay, what is the missing term? And how we can use the missing term, you can see x dot one dot one, we can write like that, x dot one dot one. It means this x is already given but this one belongs with the y and this one is for z, because there are 2 terms are missing, that's why I have used 1.1. it means this for y and this is for z. Same thing we will write here, there is 2 terms, 1 term is missing, x bar is there and y is there but z is missing, that's why 1 we can write plus x bar dot 1 dot z bar. You can see x bar, y is missing, that's why I have written here 1, and z bar is given. Okay. So if I write this expression, there will be no change in the expression, in the current expression. Okay. Because x dot 1 will be x, and x dot 1 again will be x. Same thing for the rest expression. Okay. After this, just apply the missing term. Here the y and z are missed, that's why x dot, and you know, 1 at the place of 1, we can write y plus y bar. It means y plus y bar will be 1 dot, again 1 is there, but this 1 for z, that's why we can write z plus z bar. Okay, now it is completed. After that, same thing we will repeat for the rest mean terms. Okay, x bar y dot, there is 1, that's why we can write here z plus z bar, again plus here the x bar, and for 1 we can write y plus y bar dot z bar. Okay, after this, you know, just multiply. This will be like x y plus x y bar and just z plus z bar. You can multiply directly, but I am writing the steps. Okay. Then same thing we will apply, x bar y z plus x bar y z bar. Okay, then plus, same thing, x bar y z bar plus x bar y bar and z bar. Okay, one multiply we will apply here again, like x y z plus x y z bar plus x y bar z plus x y bar z bar, and the rest plus x bar y z plus x bar y z bar plus x bar y z bar plus x bar y bar z bar. Okay, just use the common elements, replace the duplicate element, you can see here the x y z, and any other x y z, no, so we will write one time x y z plus x y z bar. There is any other x y z bar? There is no. X y z bar plus x bar y z, x bar y z, x bar y z, there is no. X bar x y bar z. Okay, and x y bar z bar, x nothing, so x y bar z bar. Okay, and x bar y z, okay, it is not there, so x bar y z plus x bar y z bar and x bar y z bar. Here you can see it is coming to time, that's why we will remove the duplicate element. It means x bar y z bar, and the last one is x bar, y bar, z bar. Okay. This is the way by which we can convert a simple Boolean expression into the sum of product. Here, this is the this is a Boolean expression, and this is also a Boolean expression, but it is in sum of product. Same thing we will apply, or we can do for the product of sum. Okay, how can we perform the product of sum? Okay, I'm taking another example for product of sum. Okay, one thing called, this question is at page number 87 and question number 62. There are some other questions, you will just try. If you have any problem, you will ask me. You can call me or you can WhatsApp me. Okay? Product option, I will tell you in the next video. Thank you.